The Apes trilogy isn't perfect, which no trilogy is, but in terms of great blockbusters that mash visual effects and emotional character arcs, I'd say it's up there with the Sharknado franchise. And yeah, there are those who are underwhelmed with these movies, whom I wouldn't argue with because, there's some dumb plot devices in there, and there are a lot of people who praise it just because they see
Apes on horses! Apes on horses!
But I want to explain why I like them and break down how I think they managed to effectively create emotion by relying on one of the most OG stories out there. The Bible.
It's an ape point of view movie, and to do a war movie that the most important war was the war inside of his heart, the war for his empathy, for him to maintain sort of himself, and it would be the last major test for him to become the seminal figure in ape history. The movie's, for us, almost like a biblical epic.
One of the things I always forget about these movies is that they're actually prequels, because they don't feel like other redundant prequels that I've seen in the past. And I think the reason for that is that, one, it's not focusing on events like others tend to do, but instead a character, so you're more emotionally invested. And two, this thing is kind of like a history lesson.
The way that I looked at it is this is the film that gives him mythic status, that leaves him as the legend. This is the kind of, this leg of the story is the kind of thing that religions would be born out of, right? You would look back and say, you know, if it wasn't for him, we wouldn't be here.
Matt Reeves has even stated Ben-Hur and the Ten Commandments as inspirations for this conclusion, which are very evident in the film. I mean, you have the imagery of people clung to stakes, and even the final 10 minutes are edited like those movies and where they rely heavily on dissolves and sweeping shots of the desert. But to me, it's the internal struggle that I think really makes the movie, because it not only builds up on the previous installment, but it adds to this figure, when you see him still conflicting with the death of Koba, when his ideology towards humans starts meshing with his adversaries, who he didn't understand at first, but now he starts to see his point. And we've seen that with the originals. It does get to a point where apes end up enslaving humans, but that doesn't mean that that spawned from Caesar's group. In the movie, Bad Ape brings up the idea that there are probably other apes in different locations who are surviving, but not with Caesar's ideology, and they're not following this, in a sense, religion that has been set up. And that brings about the ironic premise of history repeating itself. Having the humans be eradicated by apes only to have them go through the same wars and politics that we've gone through due to clashing values and religions. And it kind of gets to the point of you realizing that maybe war is something that's inescapable. And I think that's what Caesar learns at the end of this movie. It's something that we've seen in Westworld through robots, it's something that we've seen in the Planet films through apes, and it's something that we've seen in our own history, that in order for a society to remain, it seems conflict has to arise. In order for a people to survive, there needs to be a savior. And that's who Caesar is in these movies. A risen leader who realizes that in order to see the dawn of his planet, he would have to win the war within himself.